I think this might be a target here. Oh, yeah? Ooh! Come on.
Over 1,000 kilometres north, where the blistering temperature is 10 degrees hotter, the ferals are back on their honey hole lease after chasing a poacher away.
The poacher found a patch over there. No, we just can't afford to be losing any gold.
Look at that. A nice piece of gold. Hey, Rhino, I reckon I got about a 3 or 4 grammy here, mate.
You legend, Levi.
Good effort tracking down that poacher, but, you know, let's put that behind us, mate, cos we're back on the gold here and Kim's not far away with the digger, so I reckon we got a couple extra spots here to dig.
Beautiful, mate. It'll be nice to have some gold for him when he turns up and put a smile on his face. We've got the boss man bringing the digger out. Once we can start moving some dirt, we're going to start really chipping away at that 40-ounce target.
Afternoon.
Afternoon. How you going, mate?
I'm good. Ryan.
Doing, buddy?
Hey, thanks for bringing the old girl back out.
The ferals need Kim's 8-ton excavator to scrape away layers of dirt so they can detect deeper laying gold nuggets.
So we had an intruder, a parasite on site.
Did, mate, yeah. But, mate, I got some drone footage for you.
Oh, good.
And got his licence plate number, got a clear view of his face.
No, I'll have a look. Anyway, keep an eye on it. People are coming out here pretty badly now.
Yep.
So, yeah, mate, good luck.
Hey. Okay. Thanks.
Let's get it unloaded.
Let's get this off.
We got that digger! With no door, but that's all right. We got a digger.
Yeah, I'm not spoiling us anymore with good gear.
Well, it feels good.
So you really need 4 ounces. 4 ounces is really not negotiable, right?
And as long as we've got 4 ounces a week, happy days.
Well, I'd like to see a lot more than 4 ounces a week. 4 ounces a week is your minimum.
Minimum 4 ounces a week.
Or on the bikes, all right?
On the bike, right. We're out of here.
OK. And
4 ounces a week. You know, Kim's really dropped the bomb on us this time.
Think of it this way. If we don't get 4 ounces a week, we're not going to make 40 ounces for the season. So it's a kick up the bum we need.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
One day at a time, we'll be sweet.
We've really had a disastrous start to the season. At this point in time, Kim North is our best option.
I'll be spending a fair bit of time in the digger, I think, out of the elements, while the other fellows detect.
The ground's a little bit hard through here. I'll see what we can do.
It's only Bridget's second week on the digger. She'll use the blade at the front to scrape away surface dirt and Spinifex grass to expose virgin ground for Ryan and Levi to detect.
Woo! Dust cloud! Still learning with the digger. I'm giving it my best shot. Practice will get there.
Definitely warming up. It's got to be creeping up to over 40 degrees. Bridget's a real trooper. It's hard enough just being out here, let alone being a pregnant lady.
Little diggers just
ploughing
through.
Got a target. Get close and it's sounding good. Come on, baby. Whoa-ho. Tell you what, she's a noisy one. Woo! Oh, there she is. You little ripper. Man, that's a nice little chunk. That's got to be at least 3 grams, I reckon. Oh, well, better keep moving.
Hey, Levi and Ryan, I'm a bit worried about how much oil's coming out of the arm of this digger. I noticed a little bit earlier, but it's just dripping out. Do you guys want to come and have a look?
No worries, mate. We'll be over in a sec.
Roger.
It's not looking good there, Bridget. It must be coming out of one of the seals, eh? On the ram there.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, no, that's not good at all. Is it mainly just when you move the boom?
No, it's just a constant drip. I noticed a few bits of oil going down and looked down again and...
Jeez, leaking.
Yep. Out of that top seal there for that main ram, I think.
Yeah, well, it's pouring out, isn't it?
Yeah.
It'll have to go in and...
It'll have to go back in.
Get a new seal kit and everything put through it.
Just came back out.
The excavator's boom is controlled by hydraulic pressure, but extreme temperatures can cause the oil in it to overheat and damage the seals designed to stop it leaking. If too much fluid is lost, the pressure drops and the boom can no longer be used.
It makes our job harder without having the bucket on the digger working properly. It's invaluable to be able to scrape the dirt and soften it up before you push it, but there's no fixing that here.
No. Maybe I can get a rag or something around that. Let's just soak it into the rag.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, for the meantime, we'll just try wrap it up, capture it there.
No worries, I'll grab a rag, mate, and see how we go, but we've got to do something.
The rag will slow the leak and stop abrasive particles of dirt getting into the hydraulic system and damaging it further.
Just switch your on bridge and lift the arm right up.
That's so frustrating, you know. The season's halfway through. We've only got 5.5 ounces. You know, we've still got 34 ounces to go, and there's no way we're going to be finding it with a machine like that.
I think it's kind of stopped having the arm right open. Just relieved a bit of pressure on it.
Cool.
Just lifting the bucket right up with the ram right open. This seems to have stopped that leak a little bit.
Machine's just come back out for us. You would think all this stuff would be fixed on it. I've been using it for a day and that's it.
Non-stop with this digger.
Hey, dude, I just got bridge to lift it right up.
Yep.
And open up the ram. It's not leaking anymore.
Oh, lovely.
So I might just tie that around it.
Yep.
Little rag. Look at that. Just like a Band-Aid.
Oh, mate, I hope your uncle's going to understand that, you know, this is nothing that we've done.
All right, sweet. Well, I'll just take it easy and I'll let you guys know if it keeps leaking.
All right, we better get out of the way. Our digger's still going, but we're having to nurse it through. So it is slowing us down. It'd be nice if that was running flat out, but if we don't get that 4 ounces, Kim's going to kick us off the lease. I really hope it's enough to keep your uncle happy, mate. I mean, I know we've had to nurse that machine a little bit, but he did say 4 ounces.
Well, we can only try, and that's what we've done. So hopefully he's keen to give us another week to try and prove ourselves.
Well, one way to find out.
That's it.
Six ounces. Spewing, mate. Not quite there.
I still think it's a fair effort, but he's a businessman through and through. He doesn't make money by, keeping losses.
The ferals are almost an ounce short of their boss, Kim North's, weekly target, set just 5 days ago.
Well, we'll give Kim a call and let him know how much we got and see what he has to say.
It's the ball's in his court. I still think it's a fair effort, but he's definitely going to move us on, mate.
Hey. Hey. Good, mate. How you going?
Yeah, I'm all right. What's happening?
Oh, we just did a weigh up. We got 3.16 ounces.
Okay. I'm assuming you're packed up and ready to go.
Oh, not quite, mate.
I don't know what you're doing out there, but you're not finding much gold.
Well, we could definitely find more gold if we didn't have breakdowns.
Yeah, so the machine broke down. But you've got to
do
the hours, boys.
Mate, we're making the most of our time out here. Just give us
you have a little bit that we'll stop doing, all right? Give it a few days, if you're not making it, well, it's time to get up.
No worries, mate.
Your boys better get lucky. That's all I can tell you.
Yeah.
All righty.
We won't let you down, mate.
All right, you guys, be safe.
Thanks,
all right, Kim.
Thanks, buddy. You take care.
See you, mate.
I really thought that was borderline then.
I know.
He just thought about it for a bit too long.
I think if we got any less gold than what we did, there was a fair chance that he would have thrown us off then.
Yeah, absolutely.
With a bit of anxiety waiting for Kim's response, he is a businessman. It needs to be financially viable out here for us to continue. We need to get that 4 ounces next week.
We need to. Yeah. Oh, well, pack this up and get some more gold. Pretty damn lucky.